Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back to another After Effects tutorial. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to morph one object like this to another object just like this. I'm also going to be showing you how to effectively composite your morph with the background. So then it looks like the object really is morphing before the audience's eyes. And once you've mastered this effect, you can get really funky with it. You can even use it as a transition like this. So to create this effect, you're going to need three pieces of footage. First, you're going to need the footage with the original object that you want to morph from. Second, you're going to need the object that you want to morph to. And third, you're going to need a clean plate. A clean plate is a fancy piece of film terminology for what is effectively a plain background without the actors, or in our case, objects, in the shot. It's something that's really important to making sure that any of your effects come out well, even if you don't think you're going to need it. First, we need to bring the object we want to morph from and to into our composition, and then retime them so there's an overlap between the two clips. This overlap is going to be how long it takes to morph from the first object to the second, but this can always be retimed later. Now we just need to create masks around both of our objects. You can do this the traditional way and just use the pen tool, or you can use the roto brush tool. To do this, just highlight your object with the roto brush, and then go to layer, auto trace, and then you can either select the current frame or the entire work area. If you select the current frame, it'll create a mask for that one singular frame that you have selected. Or you can select work area, which will create an entire mask that will move with your object in the work area you have selected at the moment. This is great for an object that's going to be moving when you want it to morph, but I'd recommend learning with a static mask to begin with when mastering this effect. We've just got to repeat this process now for both objects, so we've got a mask around both. If you are using the roto brush tool to create your masks, make sure to go in and delete the roto brush once you've created your mask. Now that we have masks for both of our objects, we just need to copy and paste the masks from one object to the other. So take the pepper mask and copy it and paste it onto the apple layer, and copy and paste the apple mask onto the pepper layer. The last thing you need to do is change the original mask to add, and do this on both of the layers. And now that we've got all our tricky masking out of the way, it's time to start morphing. Now to morph from one object to another, we're going to use the reshape tool, which you can find in the effects and presets tab in After Effects. Once you have the reshape tool, just bring it onto your first layer, and then you just need to change the source mask to the pepper mask, so the object we're morphing from, and the destination mask to the apple mask, since that's what we want the pepper to transform into. At the beginning of the transition, we just need to hit the percentage keyframe button and leave it at 0, and then we need to move to the end of our morph and change the percentage up to 100, meaning that at the very end of our morph, our pepper is going to be morphed completely into the shape of our apple mask. Now, as you can see, the pepper has morphed into the apple, but it's morphed in a weird shape and not quite in the direction I want it to travel. Now to fix this issue, there's a blue line available between these two masks, and I can drag this around at different points of the mask, so different areas of the pepper will be stretched out into the apple mask in a different way. To add more of these lines, make sure you've got the reshape tool selected, and then hold Alt on your keyboard, and you can add a point on either of the masks, and then drag that around so you can keep reshaping your object to morph in the direction that you want it to. Now that we've created the morph for our pepper, we just need to create it for our apple. There's an easy way to do this by just copying the reshape effect, going into the reshape effect's keyframes and going back to the first one that we've created, so that they're definitely going to be in sync. Going to the apple layer and then pasting our effect, but then the apple, as you can see, is going to morph from the apple into the pepper, which isn't the effect we want. To do this, all we've got to do is just reverse the percentages, so it's going from 100 to 0% instead of 0 to 100. And as you can see now, it's morphing from the pepper into the apple. The last thing we need to do is just adjust where the blue lines are so that we get a fluid morph that we're happy with. I'm happy with how my apple morphs now, so I'm just going to unsolo the layer. And now we can see our transition as it completes from one to the other. Now that we have the objects morphing from one to another, we just need to change how they fade in. You can do loads of different things for this. You can do a glitch transition, or one of my favorites is the CC burn film effect. This will give you a really weird option where it looks like the object is almost revealing out of it. But for now, I'm going to stick with a simple opacity fade between the two. But this is an area where I definitely recommend bringing another transition in to really bring this effect to life. Now we need to add the background back to our video. And this is where the real trick lies, is making sure the shadows interact with the object as it morphs from one to another with the surrounding area. Now the shadows are what are going to sell the morph to the viewer. they'll be able to believe that the morph is really happening before their eyes if there's nothing else wrong with the video. But if your shadows are jumpy or non-existent and don't blend with the scene, the viewer will know something's wrong and they won't quite believe the morph. So here's how to get realistic shadows back into your video and have the shadow move with the object as it morphs. So to add shadows, we're actually just going to use our original footage, since it has the most accurate shadows of our objects. Now we're just going to retime and replace the footage where it was before, and as you can see now, we've got the shadows and we've got the objects looking like they were originally. Unfortunately, at the end of our transition, our apple doesn't really have accurate shadows and it suddenly flicks from the pepper's shadows into the apple's shadows, which isn't ideal. To fix this, we're going to go to the pepper's original layer, and then we're going to change its opacity during its transition from 100% down to 0. By doing this, it means that the shadow is going to fade away from the peppers into the apple's shadow that it casts onto the chopping board. Now, where this is effective in creating better shadows, we've now developed a new problem, where the apple is partially visible as it's fading in before it's finished its morph, which isn't the effect we're going for. Unfortunately, by doing this, we've developed a new problem. The apple now fades in during the transition, which is not the effect we want. So we're going to use the clean slate here to replace the background where the apple's fading in. To do this effectively, just create a mask around the affected area where the apple's faded in, so that the clean slate replaces that area above the apple, but we still get the transition of the shadows fading. You just need to adjust this mask to cover out any area of the things that are changing. And as you can see now, the clean plate is removed where the apple was fading in before. Now the final trick to really selling this effect is adding your own artificial shadow, which you can do by going to the Effects and Presets tab and finding a drop shadow effect, and adding it to the first object that you've morphed, and then adjusting it so it matches the shadows and lighting conditions that already exist in your composition. So as you can see now, I've added a fake shadow in underneath my pepper, which looks pretty good. And as you can see now, the shadows really do move with the objects as they morph, and they've got a little bit more weight to them.
Thanks for watching, guys. If you have watched to the end, maybe consider subscribing or checking out some of my other videos. I'll see you later.